Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial. Here I will show you how you can connect Ambrose MySQL in the NetBeans IDE. In order to get started, you need to install your MySQL database. Here I have installed I'm using the XAMPP. MySQL database coming with the XAMPP package bundle. So it can be any database. Feel free to install any version of the database that you want. Here we do it with MySQL from XAMPP, I've said. So what you have to do is to start the service, and here you can see then the service running in this port 3306. Then the next thing is to start our Apache XAMPP. Let's go to PHP my admin, things should be here. And from here, you are going to see the database that you want to access. We want to access this database which contains a student and the user. So, so then we go to, remember the name of database is Spring Boot here. Then we come here on the projects. Here you have this tab here with service, and in the service here you can see that you browse here the first time you see the driver list, then you come here, then select which database you want is MySQL with the driver, then click connect using connection string, and here we have it's a local host because it is in this computer, and this port 3306 correspond to this port in which MySQL is listening to. So we are going to connect to that port, and here should be the name of the database you want to connect to. You want to connect to the database, remember here is Spring Boot. So we enter here the name of the database, Spring Boot, and by entering here you can see that the database name will be automatically inserted here in the connection string or the GDBC URL. Then come here, you have to enter the username. Here the username of my database is Spring Boot, and the password can be anything. I've entered my password, then that is it. Then the next thing is to go to text. The connection is okay. Here you can see that it has been successful here. Then we click next. Here, come back here. You don't have any schema, it's just a small database. Then next here, then finish. Then you can come, if you browse here, you can see Spring Boot is highlighted here. If we go, we scroll here, now we can see our student and users database, the same thing that we have here under our PHP my admin. Then in this case, now you can do whatever you want, you can view them. Can select here, it's empty, or you can also come here, try to view if anything was there, not empty here. Okay, we have one user here, and in the students here you also have many students that you can see here from the this list here. So yeah, that is it. Then if you want, now you can disconnect, or if you want to run some commands, yeah, you just have to enter again the password to reconnect. Here are some other databases. So that is it. Feel free, you can enter your SQL script queries here and run as you want here. Then in a bit, this is how you can connect your SQL database here to NetBeans. And if you want to add a new driver, you can come here, download the jar file, add it here, depending of any database that you want. Then that is it, what can be retained here. So I hope this is the first step for the next project that you are developing. So if you like it, do not forget to drop your comments, subscribe to this channel. See you soon for the next tutorial. Bye.